Let's talk about it. What up, Twist Gang? What up, Twist Squad? It's your girl, Money Two Times Up in here, and I am back with another YouTube video. But this time, this is gonna be like a vlog. This is like my first vlog in a whole grip since I think like the last time I made a vlog, I was like either as a freshman or a sophomore at my alma mater, which is Cabrini University. So what you read in the title description is correct. We're going to talk about, you know, my opinions about Cabrini closing down and what good talking about the school without repping it. And then we're just going to talk about, you know, everything else that you see on the title description. So first and foremost, we just want to address the elephant in the room and say, yes, I know it's been a while since I last, you know, recorded and showing my face. It's not because, you know, I don't love you guys. It's because I've been super busy and still trying to figure out, you know, what new content I should post on my channel. I'm going to start posting, you know, gaming videos, and like I'm trying to figure out if I should do no commentary or commentary, because like I hate talking sometimes, so I may go for the no commentary route, but we'll see how I'm feeling. Also, if you guys didn't get a chance to see, or if you don't see it in the socials right here, I am on Twitch. I'm still trying to figure out Kick right now, so as of right now, instead of Kick, we're just going to be streaming on Twitch. So give me a follow on Twitch. It's maybe small for you, but it helps me out a lot, and plus, you know, I'm trying to get there with my friends, you know, help out a first time streamer. I've been streaming on Twitch for about a week now, and it's been very fun, it's been very cool, and honestly, I can't wait to push out more content since I got, you know, my capture card. Another thing is that I graduated from the school, finished my undergrad, and I'm still trying to figure out, you know, if I want to pursue a different path of life. Like, I'm still trying to like find graphic design positions, graphic design jobs. So if you know anybody that needs a graphic designer, feel free to drop in the comments and I'll personally DM you, or actually, you know, just go on my Discord. I'm gonna drop my Discord in the description. I'm always free and open to talk to you guys. I do plan on making a Discord server for you guys to come in and talk, you know, just to like get this shit on the road since I have more time now. Post-grad life, honestly, it's been different, it's been weird, especially with finding out that, you know, Cabrini is closing down. So for those of you who don't know, Cabrini University, it's in Radnor, PA, and they're closing down because they have been in debt for, I believe, going like for like 5 years. Like, this started way before I even came to the school in 2019, so this happened while I was in high school. And they've been in debt, like they started with like $46 billion, and they wound up being in debt like under that amount. Like, they blew it all. Like honestly, I can say it's the president's fault. It's the president and the school's fault at the time, because they decided to spend money on a fucking parking garage that they only allow faculty and commuters to use. And mind you, you got a lot of students who live on campus and have cars, and they have to park either at their residence hall, or if they got a little parking ticket, they're allowed to park anywhere, but they just can't park at the garage. So they can park at any residence hall or etc. And if you don't have a parking pass, you got to park at the gym. And mind you, the gym is very far. Like, imagine living in, you know, an upper class building, like at the apartments, and you have to walk from there to, you know, the gym just to get your fucking car. Like, and they don't allow on-campus students to park at the garage. I'm just like, why the fuck not? Like, the money that that was used to fund it should be like getting back to the kids, you know, because we paid our money out of our pocket to make sure you have that fucking garage. And you mean to tell me that only staff and commuters are allowed to use it, nobody else? That's just fucking weird. My opinion about the school closing, because, like, you know, like them, like Villanova buying them and all.
Hold up.
What's wrong, girl?
I know that I don't say what I think
you say. My opinion is that, like, why the fuck would you sit back here and say that you guys are closing down? And especially that you're closing your doors legit next year in 2024. And you just fucked over class of 25, class of 26, and class of 27. These people sat back here, this school sat back here, right? Despite them knowing that they're in debt and they may close down, they still took a class of 2027's money and, you know, just pocketed. And, like, no one did want to close it, so now they're closing. It's a lot of people in the comment section. So if you don't follow the school, you know, just go on their account, look at a recent post that just has like the Cabrini logo in it, and you will see everybody in the comment section just going off on them. And I'm just like, I don't fucking blame you. Like, I would be pissed too if my child committed to a school that knew damn well that it was about to close down, and now I gotta sit back here and find another school that may accept my daughter or any child as well. Cause, you know, now you got St. Joe's, Eastern University, I believe Chestnut Hill College, Rosemount, every other school like trying to accept Cabrini transfer students. So to any Cabrini student that's in this situation right now, just watching this video, my heart goes out to you. Y'all don't deserve, because a fucking school decided to be a fucking dickhead. And honestly, in my opinion, they should have just closed the doors after class of 26 came.
Get your ass up. We gotta get the fuck out of here now.
So once everybody graduated, you know, everything would be all good, because now you got the current seniors of class of 24 are going to have to stress and make sure that they pass their classes. Otherwise, if they're not able to graduate, they have to go to a different school and start over. And, you know, for class of 25, these are juniors now. And after they finish their year, they got to start their senior year at a different school. And it just keeps getting worse for that. But they didn't care. They didn't really think of that. This is a school that's known for being very, like, you know, prejudiced towards, you know, people of color. Like, if you didn't see it in all my episodes of my podcast, whether it's Surviving PWI with my co-host Jeff. Speaking of Surviving PWI, we're taking a break. It's nothing wrong. It's because Jeff is really busy with his schedule, and, you know, he did give me a heads up about it, so you won't be seeing like new episodes of Surviving PWI for a while. Not only that, like, I don't feel comfortable recording when he's not here, and I don't want to feel like I'm taking the credit. So I'm gonna just wait. Or if y'all see a podcast, if you see like another Surviving PWI episode, my friend, that means Jeff had talked some sense to me and told me that I can record, and just, you know, wait until he comes back. So there's gonna be new new episodes about that, and stay tuned with that. But yeah, like, we had, like, you know, so many stories about issues with Cabrini. And, you know, I, like, this one submission right here, you know, I can relate it the most, because this is a graphic designer, a former graphic designer that I personally knew and am personally cool with. And, you know, I've known, you know, situations that, you know, involve people, you know, involving people, you know, not doing what they're supposed to do, but it doesn't mean you treat them with the utmost, you know, disrespect and disregard. So as I was reading, and I'm about to read it to y'all, what this former graphic designer at Cabrini University has said about his experience there, it reminded me of a situation where I had encountered a racial incident with a graphic design professor at my school. So I want to read you my friend's response. So he has said, he has said, and he's in his alias, forgive me YouTube, don't take me down, his alias, his name that he wants to go by is Church Fucker. If you guys don't know why he wants to be called Church Fucker, it's because at our school we had a chapel, and he was known for having intercourse inside the chapel, and it was the funniest shit I've ever heard. Like, it took me to like junior year to find out, like, I heard about this situation since my junior year, but it took me to like half of my junior year going on senior year to find out who was the church fucker, and I'm just like, dude, you're out of pocket. So this is his story. He said, okay, where do I start? I was at Cabrini for 3 years until they decided to kick me out due to academic probation. As I attended Cabrini, I was unseen an immeasurable amount of mental and emotional pain from the school. Cabrini made me feel like I'm such a failure. I couldn't play a sport that I used as a getaway to release all my stress, and I lost my love for graphic design. I took graphic design for 3 years in high school and had entered a contest and had going through pretty harsh criticism on my work, but I never felt so little and unfit as a graphic designer until I came to Cabrini. No matter how hard I worked on my designs and the countless thumbnails, and due to my own criticism, the amount of time I restarted the whole project from the beginning just because I didn't like how my original design ended up looking. But I used to feel that after every restart, I improved and produced better designs no matter what I did or tried. It was insignificant. My first graphic design teacher, I'm gonna say this man's name because fuck you Keith Humphreys, you are a piece of shit and I hope you never teach ever again. Fuck you. My first graphic design teacher, Keith, and Keith was also my graphic design teacher as well, so I got something for his ass. Had extreme prejudice and favoritism in the class. It got to a point that he tried to fail me, so when I went to the dean of students, he said I'm straight, but Keith still had the last laugh because he contacted my coach and told lies such as I never do my work or that I'm always late to class. It was a night class, may I add. But after everything was snowballing for me, never managed to get out of my funk and get out of academic probation. I even took extra classes to help me, and I used every resource that Cabrini quote unquote had, and I wasn't successful. I felt so lost to work so hard, and they just kicked me out because I was being quote unquote lost cause. I love feeling like a failure, and every time I come back to design and I have a massive panic attack. So the only thing I can say about Cabrini, about this Cabrini news, is fuck Cabrini, y'all can choke on my knob, and that's what they fucking get for giving up on people who try their best to succeed. Yeah, honestly, that's just how it be. Like, these teachers here, they're not here. Some of these teachers are here for a check. They're not here to help you. And you got some teachers who are legit here for you. Like, I had some graphic design teachers who are legit good people and are legit here, you know, to help you. They fired one good graphic design professor. He was also a fine arts teacher, and everybody fucking loved him. When I say everybody fucking loved him, everybody loved him. When he had emailed us saying that, you know, he got terminated, I'm just like, Cabrini, what the absolute fuck is you doing? Because y'all did it because he calls too much. He's a fucking fine arts teacher that draws shit like this every single day. So you mean to tell me you can't afford to pay a teacher? Because you that cheap? But you can afford paying the chair of the department, but you can't afford a fine arts teacher? Get the fuck out of here. How you manage to have like a very well-known, popular, and famous artist as a professor at school, but you can't keep a fine arts teacher because your ass was just that cheap? You laid off a lot of good workers because y'all were cheap. So as we're talking about Keith, I found a screenshot. I'm gonna post it right here. Hopefully Future Monty posts it right here for you guys to read, or just post it somewhere in the middle of the screen, because I will read it with you. So this right here is the screenshot that I have received on December 12th, 2019. So I was a freshman. Keith was being very prejudiced and very like racist towards me because I had emailed him ahead of time and I stated that, you know, I need to go home early because I have like important matters to address. And, you know, at first, like, mind you, this was an email. He said, you know, all right, you know, all good. He said, you know, just sit through 3 presentations and then you can go home. I said, 3 presentations. He did not let me go home. He refused to let me go home. So he was about to let little old Sally right here, sat back here, was about to go home. He was about to let 3 people leave early. But he gave me trouble when I asked to go home early. Mind you, it's in documented form. I emailed him an audit. So technically, he is not listening. He's not listening to his student, because if I would have got up and walked out from his class, it would not be good. But anyways, I'm gonna pop the screenshot on the screen. I'm gonna just read it. He said, Armani, first of all, you were incredibly rude tonight. Asked me on multiple occasions to leave class early. Dumbass. I emailed you saying that I gotta go. This is our final project. Our class people are presented. Have some respect. Fuck you. Think I got 1 or maybe 2 subpar logo sketches for you. The class tonight is the first I'm seeing any design work for a final project. We didn't have class Thanksgiving week and you were absent last week. Dude, I told you about my situation. I was going through like very bad anxiety and mental health. I've emailed and reached out to everyone, asked me to send updates, send me progress, a PDF, nothing from you. That's cap, because I did email him my progress. He was just pissed off that I called him out. I'm here, everybody, to give you my professional opinion on your work, and you needed it. I also repeatedly asked everyone tonight if they submitted me. It's just, like, just look at that. Like, look at that. Like, just look at that. Like, he mainly just used this time to basically, you know, try to come at me and berate me, because I just told him, I said, bro, can I fucking leave early? Like, I came at his neck because, one, you're going to let 3 white people leave before me. And I personally emailed you and told you that I got to go. And he wasn't, like, listening. He felt some type of way. So, after, you know, seeing that email, I just gave him, like, a bad evaluation and all that. Like, he's saying all this. That grade was a D. I was one of the best designers in the class. I had an A and B in that class. But the moment I just challenged his authority, he got his feelings and basically just said all that. So, yeah, I'm not going to finish reading all that, but you get the point. And if I manage to find, like, the screenshots of the email I sent to him, I'll pop it on here as well. But honestly, like, Keith, if you're watching this, I hope you never get ass for the rest of your life. I hope, and I think that you're married. I hope that your wife never satisfied you. I hope you never be satisfied a day of your life. I hope when your kids grow up, they hate you for being racist and being rude. I hope. And I'm not wishing it, I'm not the type of person to wish it on anybody, but for you, you racist son of a bitch, you deserve it. You deserve it, because you're gonna sit back here and fuck over my man's the church fucker because he came at your neck. You're gonna fuck over my other friend that I know, because she reported you, and you know she was a goddamn good designer, and you got in your feelings. You didn't like having your ego fucked with, so you try to sit back here and you fucked over four graphic designers, because one of them had disabilities and you yelled at him because of his disabilities. So you disgusting piece of shit.
Shit just went from 0 to 100 real fucking quick.
I hope you get stung by a bee. I hope you get stung in the dick. I hope you go fucking cactus. Motherfucker, I hope you catch STDs. Because you was a sick piece of shit. And you try to fuck me over. Guess what? I graduated, bitch. So you can never, ever, ever try to fuck me over ever again. And then, you know, when I had reached out to him one time to, like, you know, have him send an old project of mine, he gonna try to say, you know, you was one of my favorite students, like, you're one of my favorite students, and it's my favorite project. First of all, fuck you, and fuck your fake nices, because I don't like you, and you don't like me. We never speak to each other. If I had every opportunity in the world, I would sit back here and spit on your shoes and call you a bitch, because that's what you are, a bitch. You make Adam 22 look better than you. Okay. Sorry about that. I had to, like, you know, take 5 a little bit because, you know, Keith, he really, really made freshman year of graphic design a living nightmare. Like, he not only, like, just came after me, like, you know, he not only, like, just came after me and everybody else, you know, because of skin and color, he also came at other people based on their designs and based on, you know, gender as well. One of my classmates had told him to fuck off because he tried to criticize them for working on Hotel Transylvania. I think it was like a, it was like, had like a very, like, you know, like a type of niche, is like the type of design niche that was mainly, you know, like spooky, gothic and all that. And he came at them and he told her, they told him to shut the fuck up, like, you know, basically fuck off. And I'm like, I'm happy that you said it because, yeah, he needed to fuck off. Another thing is, another thing I'm happy about the school shutting down is actually this. So this shirt right here, I designed this. This is the Step for Life step team that I was a part of. It was a rebranded version of ICAF Step. And honestly, I'll say this. Forever ICAF Step team. I love ICAF Step. Fuck Step for Life. And I'm actually happy that the school is closing down because y'all club is getting closed down with it. And it's really, it's just so funny because, like, you know, I would get into, you know, like, what's my issue with the step team and why am I happy that they're closing down. It's like a different story to talk about, and that probably be like either be a podcast episode or, hey, that just might be, you know, a story post on my Instagram. So, you know, follow my Instagram. It should be right here, or look in the description below as well. I would love to interact with y'all. But yeah, I designed this. After I got kicked off the team, I told them to give me back this design. So now they gotta get new uniforms, their new design is shit, and I was the choreographer, so they can't step, so now they're fucked. And I don't care. I'd rather just sit back here and sip a martini and smoke weed and watch them and watch that club, you know, crumble apart. So it's really fucking hilarious. But enough about that shitty ass team. Overall is just this. I really do feel bad for class of 24, class of 25, and class of 26. And if you're class of 27, you go into that school, I'm not gonna feel bad for you because you know that they're closing down and you're still choosing to go there. Now, if they have like a certain field that you need, you can find it somewhere else. But just not the school. It's not worth going for a whole year only for you to stress out and find another school. Just go to a different school and just start over. Like, just start fresh. Don't worry about Cabrini anymore. Like, by the time a year goes by, that school is gonna be gone next June. It's gone next June. So yeah. And then the funniest part about this whole thing is that despite, you know, the school shutting down and all that, so tell me how like a couple of the students are organizing a protest that's supposed to happen, I believe, on the 16th. But whatever this video is posted, either it happened or didn't happen or is about to happen. And I'll just say this, you just back it up, man. It's that school is shutting down. You're not about to get anywhere. And it's embarrassing. Like, it's really real life embarrassing because you really think that people really gonna care about a school that doesn't live up to its purpose. And their quote is live with purpose. It's not living up to their purpose. They say that they care about diversity, but they're not showing that they care about diversity. The black folks there care more about each other than the school itself. Actually, the people of color care more about each other than the school itself. So we had to be there for each other because the school wasn't there. And six people is suing the school. I'm not one of them, but a lot of people are. So I hope they win the case. And all I can say is it's like a bittersweet moment for me. It's like I'm more happier than sad that the school is closing down. It's like I'm happy because, you know, as I mentioned, like, fuck the school, fuck the racist people, fuck the people I'm not cool with, just fuck the school itself. But I do, but I'm sad because, you know, one, I made a lot of good friends there. I'm sad for the students that's currently in the school right now. I just feel bad for, you know, a lot of the students and people and staff in general, because there's a lot of good people in that school, there's a lot of good staff in that school, and, you know, they deserve better. And Cabrini, you fucked up. Like, you really, really fucked up with it. All I gotta say is, you know, karma sucks. And what you do to others, people will do to you. Other than that, guys, that's my vlog. That's my opinions on, you know, this whole Cabrini situation and my post-grad life. Just give y'all an update again. I am on Twitch, I'm on TikTok, and Instagram. So please follow my social media accounts down below, or on the screen right here that you see them. And also, like, you know, check out my live streams, and I'm going to start releasing more content on my YouTube channel since, again, I have more time. Other than that, thank you guys for watching. It's your girl, Mighty Two Times, signing off.